Hello everyone, here we are, Robin the Sudoku Guy with tutorial number 80. Boy, over the years we've done lots of videos, but there's always something to learn. Now in this particular tutorial, I'm going to be calling it A Difficult Puzzle Made Easy. And I got this from the Globe and Mail in Canada. Thank you, Globe and Mail. Have a look at this. First thing I see is this pattern. And I'm going to just do something unique. Quite often when I start a puzzle, I look at it, oh, something just stands out. And when I looked at this, this stood out. I'm going to put a 3 here. And I'm going to put a 2 down in here. And now you may ask the question, how did you know to do that? Let me show you. When you look at this 3 here, and then you look at this column down in here, you'll see a 3 down in here. This 3 cannot be up in this area of this block because you would be repeating a number, and that's a rule in Sudoku, you do not repeat a number in a row, column, or block. And over here, there's only one place for that 3 to go, so you put it there. Similarly, when you look down in here, how did I get that 2 there? The same thing. If you look at this column here, you have a 2, 6, and a 1. You cannot have a 2, 6, and a 1 in here. Otherwise, those numbers will be repeated in that column. A no-no. So you have to find what will fit over here. Now, we've already got a 1 and a 6. The 2 is the only 1, and has to go over on this side, so it has to go there. There's nowhere else for it to go. The same thing applied for the 3. There was nowhere else for it to go. So that's a little trick. Now, when I see that, have a look at that column, there's only 2 cells left. And we know as a rule that if there's 2 cells left in a row, column, or block, it's got to be a matching pair. So let's see what they will be. We'll put our matching pair in here. Well, it's got to be a 1. Here's a 1, and there's a 1. So there'll be a 1 in there. Okay. Now, what's the other number missing in this column? It's a 1, 2, 3. It's a 4. Okay, so we have a matching 1-4 pair. Let's put it in. If you see it, put it in. Now, so let's now go to my next point. It is unbelievable different ways that you can solve a puzzle, how you go about solving a puzzle. Some people do the willy-nilly trick. What do I mean by that? The willy-nilly trick is they just look at it and see what they find and just go from there, see what happens. The other way of doing it is having a sort of a plan, a step-by-step way to go. A procedure is another way of putting it. And I'm going to do that to start off with, okay? And we're going to do TMB, top, middle, bottom, on these blocks. Then we'll do LCR and these vertical blocks. Of course, we're now into the stage where we always look for ramification. And then we're going to be looking for cross meet. We're going to do the cross meet. After we're doing the cross meet, we then look for matching pairs, 2 empty cells, then 3 empty cells, and so on. So let's see what happens. When I look at this very quickly across there, there's only 1-1. There's only 1-2. There's only 1-3. There's no 4s. There's 2 5s. There's a 5 here and a 5 here, so we can put a little 5 over here, like so. 2 spots we can put it in. That's the Schneider method. Very valuable system, and you'll see later on the value of that system. 6s, we got 2 6s. We can put a 6 here or a 6 there. Look down, there's a 6 here. So a 6 can't be there, it'll have to be there. Okay. Now, what's the ramification of that? We now have 2 6s over here, a 6 and a 6. So we could have a little 6 in here. It can go in 2 spots. Let's put them in. That was great. Sevens. There's only one seven. Eights. There's only one eight. Nines. We have three nines. So they're all there. Middle, top, bottom. Just look at this, these set of blocks. When I look at that set of blocks and the numbers there, there's not one number in that set of blocks that is there twice. So we can't use T and B. We push down to this set now. There's two ones. I'm looking at two ones. There's a one here and a one here. We put a one over here because it can go into two spots. We put it in. There's only one two. Only one three. No fours. Only one five. There are two sixes. The top, a bottom, and a middle. They can go here or here. Have a look up. There's a six up here. So that means that this is where the six goes. Now that we have a six here and a six there, we can say, okay, over here we can have a six. Now there's two ways of looking at it. We can say six, 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 and write them all in. If you're a beginner, that's helpful. But if you're experienced, try and remember that that's supposed to be sixes in here. Nowhere else in that block, sixes will be one of those three. Sevens. Ooh, the 91 seven. Eights, only one eight. Nines. Nines. Oh, I forgot to do the nines down here, come to think of it. We have two nines here. Nine there and a nine there means we have a nine down in here and a nine here. Have a look up. Oh, there's a nine there. So, great. That's where the nine. Now we have two nines, so we can put a nine in here and a nine there. So going on, we have no twos, we have threes, fours, no fours up in here. Fives, we have a five. Five, five, five. Oh, this is interesting. Have a look at this. A five has to be on this side. Center, right, left. There's a five over here, which means that this cannot be a nine. It has to be a five. So let's put the five in. And this has to be a nine. See the advantage of putting the nine in only two spots? Very valuable. That's going to happen a lot. Now that we've got a nine, 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 we're pretty well finished with this lot. Now let's go over here. Any places where there's two numbers? Ones, no, two. There's two twos. When we put this two in here, we did not put a little two there and there. And when I put that two in here, we didn't look down here. We could have put a two in over here, there and there. Oh, glad I picked that one up. See, easy to miss a ramification. Okay, threes. It's only one three. No, there's two threes. We have a three here and a three down in here, which means we have a center, we have a left, we have a three here and a three there. Can't have one there because of this three. Good. Fours. Mm-hmm. Fours, no fours. Fives. Now this is interesting. We have only the one five, but when I put this five in, we have a five down in here. A five has to be there or there. But have a look at this block down in here. A five has to go there. And also, if I take a five here and go over this side, I can't go over here because it's all filled up. Lesson five, I think. Interesting. So therefore, if a five can't be there, because of this and because of this blocked up, the five has to be here. If the five has to be there, we know that a five is going to be down in here, and we've got a five across here, so we can have a five there, and we have a five there. Now this five took the place of a two. Now remember, we had two could be there or there. Now that the five is there, we can get rid of, we can make this a big two, which is great. Now let's see if there's any ramifications for that. Yes, there are. We have a two over here, We have a 2 down in here, so here we could have a 2 and a 2. Well, that was neat. Now, I just did the 5s. What's about the 6s? Well, that's good. Look at this. Right, left, center. So this becomes a 6, which means, now look at this. Have you noticed over here? That 6 goes, and because we only put the 6 in 2 spots, this becomes the big 6. Again, put it in 2 spots, it makes a big difference. Now that we've got a top, a middle, we're going to have a bottom over here. Let's have a look. Now up and down, oh, there's a 6 down in here, so this will have to be the 6. Way to go. Oh, that happened just in that time. Okay, moving to the 7, and there's only 1, 7, 8. There's only 1, 8. 9s. Oh, look at this. 9s. Now a 9, left, center, it's got to be in here somewhere. There's a 9 over here, so it has to be one of these. That one or that one. Put it in 2 spots. Great. Now let's do this row, this section of vertical blocks. No ones. Oh yes, there is 1, 1. Only 1, 2. No 3s, no 4s. 5s, only 1, 5. 6, we've got all the 6s. 7s, only 1, 7. Only 1, 8. Only 1. No, we got 2 9s. We have a 9 and a 9. Well, look at this. This becomes a 9. That means that this 9 goes. Look, watch this. This is the value of the Snyder method. That 9 goes, and this becomes a 9. Okay. This, therefore, has to become a 9 because we have 9, 9, 9. And therefore, because we had 3 there and there, this one has to become a big 3. It becomes a big 3. We only now have 1 left in this block. Yes, 1 cell left, because we remember with a matching pair, no other little number can go there. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's an 8. Well, what does that do? Let's have a look. So this is an 8. We have a top, a middle, and a bottom. Looking up, looking down, we have 2 8s. We have an 8 there, we have an 8 there. Okay, super. Now, what a big growth we had just because we found those new numbers. Oh boy. Now we come to the cross meet system, which is lesson 7. And I use the cross meet system pretty well for every puzzle. Okay, let's do the cross meet. We'll start with the ones. This puzzle here, this block doesn't have a 1, so here's a 1 down in here, and here's a 1, it goes across there, 1, 2, 3. 3 places, too many places, leave it. Let's take the 2s now. This block doesn't have a 2, take that 2 across there, take this 2 up this way. Wow, look what happens, we have a real big 2. Now, what's the ramification of all that? Well, let's look down to begin with. We have a left, a center. This is going to become a big 2. And this is going to be no longer a 2. So this will be our big 2 there. Now let's look across this way. Yeah, well, they're all there now. We're up there. Now let's go this direction. We have a middle. We have a top. It has to be down here in this block. There or there. Now let's look up and down. There's a 2 down there. So it cannot be there. So therefore, it comes over here into this spot. This becomes a 2, and therefore that 2 goes. Now, the ramification of that, we have a 2 here and a 2 here, a left and a right. The 2 has to be this one here. Wow. That was a great progress. Now we got 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. We got all the 2s. Whee! Okay. Now let's go to 3s. If we take this 3, there's no 3 across here to cross with. Okay, go this way. See if there's a 3. There's a 3 down in here. So if we go up there, we get One, two, three. Too many. Okay. Fine. Fours. No fours at all. Fives we've done. Sixes we've done. Sevens. Now, I think it's in number 46. No. Tutorial number 77. I cover this little trick. It's a really handy trick to know. Have a look at this. This seven coming across here means that this cannot be a seven. There's only two cells left in that block, and they have to be a seven. So let's put them in. Now, having done that, you have a left, you have a center. Seven has to be on the right here, and we have a seven here. So this is going to be a seven, and that's going to be a seven. No, this is going to be, this is what we call a triplet or 3x3. We might as well put all the other numbers. No, maybe I'll leave it later. Just remember that there's one other number that goes there, and I think it's a four somewhere in there. Okay, very good. Seven, eight. Let's do the eight now. There's no eights. Well, there's no eights in here, but here again, we use the same system that we have with the seven. The eights go across there, which means that this can be an eight and that can be an eight. Let's continue on. This block here doesn't have an 8. Go across there, can't have an 8 there. Take this 8, go up there, can't have an 8 there or there. Whee! Whoopee! That becomes a big 8. Now, let's look at all the ramifications of that. Well, this 8 goes, okay, and therefore this becomes a big 8, okay. 8, 8, 8. Good. We've gone across. Now let's go down. Left, right. An 8 could be there or there. Look across. Oh, there's an 8 already there. So it can't be there. It has to be here. So let's put the 8 in there. Now, we have two 8s now across here. We have a bottom. We have a top. And they have to be in the middle here, this one or this one. Let's look up. There's an 8 up there. So it can't be there. It has to go there. Way to go. Fantastic. Now, that's interesting. Now we have an 8 on the right. We have an 8 on the left. Continuing on, ramifications again. So this cannot be an 8 anymore. This becomes the 8. And if that becomes the 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, I think we've got all the 8s just in that one technique. The cross meat system. Fantastic. Let's push on. Nines. I think all the nines are there already. Fantastic. Now what do we do? Well, now I haven't. No, just a minute. I went up to 8 here, just in cross meet, and got all that as a result. But there are other places where we can do a cross meet, I'm sure. Let me see. Yeah, have a look at this 7, just for fun. Go up this way, means that you can't have a 7 there or there. You can't have a 7 there, either 7. The only place a 7 can go is here and here. Now, here comes the rule of exclusion. If in this block the 7 can only go there or there, we can now get rid of this 7. And this becomes the big 7. Okay, if that becomes a big 7, we can 7, 7, 7. Yeah, that one of these is going to be a 7. And gosh, this is interesting. There's only one left in this whole block, and it's a 1, 2, 3. It's a 4. Okay, let's put it in. Which means that in this block, we only have two cells empty. No, we have these two cells as well. Okay, in that row. I'll come back to that in a minute. Oh, here's something. Have a look at this. I didn't do the threes. In this direction again. Now that we've got these filled in, we could do a cross meet here. Watch, go up this way, and then take this 3 and go this way. We could have a 3 here, and we could have a 3 there. Well, that's interesting. Okay. Pushing right along. Now getting back, it was doing the sevens, wasn't it? Down in here. If I go across here and take that seven and come down in here, we finish up with a seven here and a seven there. Now, the same rule applies. One of those two sevens is going to be a seven, which means that this cannot be a seven. Rule of exclusion. So we can get rid of that seven. Okay? And I should put the fours in here now. I think we was fours in here. Is it four and a four? That's a triplet. Okay. Continuing on. Anything else I can do with the threes? Zoom, 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 zoom. Three here. Well, look at that. If I take this three and come down in here, we can have a three here and a three there. Okay, pushing right along. It's easy to miss things. Didn't see that before. Let's now, we'll do one more cross, I think. There's a five up in here. This doesn't have a five. So here's a five here. If we go along here, that can be a five. This cannot be a five. The only places in this block for a five is down in here. And we have a matching 5-7 pair. Now, this is fun. Look at this. We have the another rule of exclusion. This five can go, which means now, remember we had 4-5-7 in here. This becomes a big four. Okay. If that becomes a big four, this four goes. And this becomes a five because we now have five's going to be there on the bottom, five's in the middle, has to be on the top here, so this becomes a five. And therefore, the four had to go, the four has to go, and this becomes a seven. Wow, that was neat. I think I've done all the cross meets I can do. If I have missed something, my apologies. There's so many things happening now that I can see we can go ahead with other things. First of all, have a look at this block in here. What's missing there? It's got to be a matching pair. Remember, another rule, matching pair plus another two empty cells equals another matching pair. Revision of that one. I'll put all these little rules in lessons and tutorials underneath the video. Okay, so what's missing in here? We have one, two. We're missing a three, and one, two, and a four. Well, that's interesting. Three and a four. Okay. Well, let's push on. Now, the next step is to look for a place anywhere in the puzzle where there's only one left or two left. Well, I can see right here, in this row here, we have two left. It's got to be a matching pair. And the matching pair would be a one and a four. So this will be a one and a four. I'm looking up and down to see if it can do anything for us. No, it doesn't. Okay, anything else where there's only two left? Yes, there is. See here, we have a three, four. We have there and there. Well, let's go, this is three, we've got three already. If it's a three there, there has to be a three over here. What's the other number missing in here? One, two, three, four. Three, four again. We're missing a three, four, that's a three, four matching pair. Let's look down. Let's look down and up. No, is that nothing yet? Okay, what about these two empty cells? Well, there's a one is missing, and it's a four. We're going to have lots of ones and fours here, and a one and a four. Okay, anything else where there's only two cells missing? I may have missed one, but let's push on because I've just noticed something. Here we have a 3-4 matching pair here, and I didn't put the four in. Now, looking around, what can we find? There's lots of places where there's three empty cells, and there's two empty cells in here. Okay. Oh, look at this. Duh. Fancy, isn't it? It's so easy to miss. Here is a 3-4. Here's a 3-4, matching pair. That cannot be a 4 because a 4 is going to be either there or there. So that becomes a 1. Okay. Ah, now this is going to help. 1. Let's see if we put a 1 in there. Now, in this row, there's only 1 left. Duh. And it has to be a 4 because the 1's already there. So this becomes a 4. And I'm going to come back to that again because I didn't do the ramifications for the 1. 1, 1. We have a 1-5 matching pair now. Now that we've got that 4, we can do all kinds of things. First of all, we go left, we go middle, top, bottom. This becomes a 4. And that's interesting. I can see all kinds of things are happening there. It's going to go boom, 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 boom. Now that's a 4, and this becomes a 3. Okay. This becomes a 3. You know, I suddenly noticed when I saw that 3 then that this was a 3-3. I forgot to put a 3-3 in here, so that means this was a 3-3. So that 3 goes, so this has to become a 3. Oh boy, it's easy to miss. Okay, now that 4-4-4. Okay, that means, oh look at this. I can see all kinds of things happening here. In this particular, because I put that 4 in, this 4 can go and it becomes a 3. And if it becomes a 3, that 3 goes and it becomes a 4. Okay. If that becomes a 4, this becomes a 3. And this 3 goes because of that 3 and that 3. So what have we got left? We got 2 left in here. Again, it's a 1 and a 4. 1 and a 4. And here we have, well, we have several there. Ah. There's all kinds of things here. We have 2. Fine. Let me do this here. We have 2 cells left in here in this block. And the 2 numbers are 3 and 7. There's a 3 down here. So that means that this has to be a 3. Okay, we're getting going mad on the 3s here. And this has to be a 7. Well, let's do the 3s first, the ramifications for the 3s. Then we'll come back to the 7. 3. They're all correct. Let's look at the 7. 7. There's a 7 here, just a minute. There's a 7 here, and there's a 7 here. Set it right. Has to be on the left. It cannot be here because that's a matching pair, and it cannot be there because of the 7. There's 2 reasons why it can't be. So this will have to be the 7. If that's a 7, ooh, well, we're left with, I can see tons of things. You probably can see it now too. We've only got 2 cells left in this block, and it's another 1 and a 4. 1 and 4 is all over the places here. Top, middle, this becomes a 7. Now, what's the ramification of that 7? Yeah, this 7 goes and becomes a 5. We're on the way to the end, I think. That becomes a 5. Therefore, because it's a matching pair, this becomes a 7. Now, let's look at see the ramifications of those numbers. Let's take the 5 first. 5. 5, that's going to be a 5. Okay, 7, we've got them all. But look at this. 7. Look at this 1. 1. If that can't be a 5, that has to be a 1. See this here? That has to be a 1, because in this one we have a 1-4. Can't be, look at this, we can't have a 1-4 there because there's a 4 there. That has to be a 1. I'm jumping ahead of myself here, I think. 1, 1, and 1. Now this 5 has to go 5, 5. It has to be there. Okay. Wow. Boy, now what we got. This is going to be interesting, because sometimes this happens. You go to the end really fast, and the temptation is to go too fast and make a mistake. Let's hope I can do it without a mistake. That one means that this can be a four. That one means that it goes and this becomes a four. Okay. Now let's look around. That four means that this becomes a one. That one means that this becomes a four. If that becomes a four, that means that this becomes a one. Okay? If that becomes a one, this becomes a four. Okay? And notice I'm self-checking. Middle, top, bottom. If that's a four, oh, it's interesting. I think we're on the way. That's a four, this becomes a one. And that means this one goes and this becomes a four. And I think that 1-4 was great, because we had a lot of fun getting to the end with the 1-4s. I think that's it. Boy, oh boy. A difficult puzzle solved without having to do any of these really advanced techniques. I'm going to list down below all the little techniques we used. And that's all for today's session. I hope you learned something. And be safe, be happy, and bye.